Hi and welcome to this video in See the Light, easy wins to improve your asset framework experience. So far we've solved all six of the problems that the engineer picked up while he was going through our work in PowerVision. That was all done using a combination of best practices in asset framework. Now however we're going to shift gears a little bit. We're moving on to the asset analytics portion. And a lot of the issues that you'll find with analytics, they won't really display themselves in an application like PowerVision. Because they've got a lot more to do with background resources on the server, how efficient the calculations are running, and how legible they are and easy to troubleshoot. For that reason, we're not going to open up PowerVision. Instead, we're going to head into Power System Explorer. And we'll start at a pretty familiar place from now on, and that's in the packaging environment. The way these next couple of examples are going to go is we're not going to apply the best practices because that would involve a lot of typing and a lot of copy and paste. Instead, what we'll do is show you a comparison between the production environment, which has been built according to best practices, and the sandbox environment, which has not. It's a nice way of putting that. So our example that we're working with is that the chief process engineer, at a glance, he wants to see whether the hourly average of the packaging rate per minute is meeting the target packing rate per minute. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the packing rate per minute, do an hourly average, compare it to the target, and if it's good or bad, depending on the value, we're going to write one of the following statuses, either far behind target, on target, ahead of target, or far ahead of target. And that's something that we would love to see. So that's what the point of this exercise is going to be. Now to see the way our analyses are configured, we can head across to the Analyses tab. For FFS01, we will find the analysis called SB underscore packing rate status. This is an expression type analysis, so we're going to have to apply supply calculation. And if we have a look, here is that calculation. It's a if statement, so you can see it starts off with if. And while it looks very complicated, it's only doing four steps. The first step is it's going to calculate the average for the last hour of the packing rate per minute attribute. It's then going to perform a subtraction between that result and the packing target per minute, so we're going to find delta based on whether the value is below 10, above negative 10, whatever the case may be. We're going to write a status, so far behind target, ahead of target, or on target. And that result will be written to a attribute called packing rate status. Now, this is the configuration that you will often start with. It's very hard to read. It's very hard to troubleshoot. And there is a much neater way of being able to code out this calculation. So if we head across to our production environment, let's say FFS08, and we have a look at the calculation called packing rate status, this is the configuration that we're looking at now. In front of you, I have put a comparison between the two, so we've just taken a screenshot, and what you can see is that in the production environment, we've split up the calculation into five different steps. The first thing we're doing is calculating the tag average. We're then importing the packing target, calculating the difference between the two, so that delta. And then we're using that value for the delta in our V packing rate status. So if V delta is less than negative 10, then far behind target, and so on. And the last step we're doing is an error check. So if the result of the V packing rate status variable is bad, we won't output the result. Else we'll put that value in. Compare that to our sandbox environment. We have written out that tag average calculation six times. Now, not only is that difficult to read, it's also bad practice because every time in our analysis we see the word tag AVG and then the parameters, so packing rate status per minute from an hour ago to now, we are doing a call to the data archive. So in our production environment, we're doing one call and getting the average and then loading that into memory for the rest of the calculation. However, in the way the sandbox calculation is configured, we are doing that call to the data archive six times. So that means this calculation is going to be very inefficient with network bandwidth, memory usage, and long term it could cause us issues. The way to find that sort of information out, how well the calculation is performing, is if we go across to, we'll start with our sandbox environment, FFS01. I can select the SB packaging rate status. If I right click and say preview results, I can give it a start time and an end time, and then go ahead and generate the results for my calculation. In front of you, what I've put is a comparison between the results that we get when previewing the results for the production environment as well as the sandbox environment. Now, the really important information is in the right-hand side column, where we've got progress, min, max, average, average trigger, and total. So just comparing between the sandbox and the production system, you can see that the maximum time taken in the sandbox was 42.9 milliseconds, whereas in the production environment, it was 0.8 milliseconds. So production's much faster. The average time to complete a calculation in production was 0.1 milliseconds, but because of the way the sandbox calculation had been configured, that is 1.6 milliseconds, 16 times slower than the production system. Having a look at our triggers, we can see our average trigger for the sandbox is every 60 seconds, while the average trigger for the production environment is an hour. Because we're looking at an hour average, we need to discuss that. That's coming up in the next video. We'll talk about scheduling. And we can see the total number of evaluations that took place. So you can see just by being a little bit careful with the way we configure our analyses, by applying a couple of variables, interim steps, reducing the number of calls to the data archive. This is a very simple example. We improved our performance on this particular calculation by 16 times. Now, on a small system, it makes a small difference. On a large system, if you've been very methodical with the way you've created all your calculations, you've put error checking, they scheduled correctly, you're going to get much more performance out of your analysis service than you will if you just go and code them the first way you think. So always a good idea to, in this case, our best practice here is to split up your variables and reduce the number of calls to the data archive. Next video, we're going to start talking about scheduling.